us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whom gift your faithful offer you, right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, we are the circumcision. We who worship through the Spirit of God, who boast in Christ Jesus, and do not put our confidence in flesh, although I myself have grounds for confidence even in the flesh. If anyone else thinks he can be confident in the flesh, all the more can I. Circumcised on the eighth day of the race of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew parentage, in observance of the law of Pharisee, in zeal I persecuted the church, in righteousness based on the law I was blameless. But whatever gains I had, these I have come to consider a loss because of Christ. More than that, I even consider everything as a loss because of the supreme good of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let hearts rejoice and search for the Lord. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds. Glory in his name, rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Our hearts rejoice and search for the Lord.
Look to the Lord in his strength, seek to serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered. You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
And hearts rejoice who serve the Lord.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus. But the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "Man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them he addressed this parable: "What man among you have 100 sheep, and losing one of them, would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds it? And when he did find it, he set his on his fire. She calls to gather her friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me because I have found the coin that I lost." In just the same way, I tell you, there will be rejoicing among the angels of God over one sinner who repents. The Gospel of the Lord. We gather today during the 51st week after the 51st Sunday, and we hear from the scripture reading. I really appreciate Bob and the up and using the projector. And yes, we work very hard on it, but the thing, we don't have people who are using it. And time for projects up, because during this time, it's very important for us to see it, because it's not allowed to have the book. And I know some of us just keep having it. And I mean, their recommendation is not, sharing it. So it's all kind of the thing. We do what we can and pray for our country for peace and unity. Difficult, I know every one of us are, looking into the new. And it's kind of sad, but only come to the Lord. The Lord will comfort us and help us, like the scripture reading today, the Gospel. The parable that Jesus used, and yet if you hear two parables, you see how merciful and how much love and care that God gives to each one of us. One that 99 sheep, on the mountain and on the hilltop, and one get lost. And yet that the shepherds left everything and go and search for the one. And then when he found it, he put it on his shoulder. And if you see the picture of the sheep on Pope Francis' shoulder, he's smiling. And that is the image of the wonderful God who always loves us, and who is looking for that one. And yet he always among us, with us, who care for us so much, love us unconditionally. So the mercy is so powerful, and repeat over and over again. And if we are one among that hundred, we are able to receive that kind of feeling, how much God loves us. But many times we are among the 99 properly. We do not know and experience and get touched by the mercy of God and who loves us that much. Same with the woman who have to tend for it, and yes, once lost, and she's searching for the whole house, weeping it, and yet when she finds, she, invites all her friends and probably the money and the energy to have the family party and celebrate more than the coin that she had lost. But that is the way of celebrating. Do we see that? Do we see that we experience in that kind of loss, and then we're able to get home again, and that experience only when we in those situations we can feel it and we know that. And that's how much God loves us, and how much God has us to love another people in the similar way. I appreciate that our community and parish, even if very poor, in need, but we always reaching out, touch so many people, and those who are outcast, and those people who that because of love and mercy, we touch their life, mean a lot. I Phone call, I have to respond. Many sick people, I have to cook and visit, and I know how that kind of feeling. But it's not like the feeling in the parable today. But may God always be with us at this time. Love and all that sadness is difficult and need healing. And the unity of our country, it needs to be there. And yes, if we surrender, and like the Archbishop at the meeting yesterday, he mentioned that if people looking for the releases, but they treating the releases is not the way of what the releases we are about. We're looking for Jesus alone, the one we're looking for and look up for. It's not about President Trump or Biden, but in who we're looking for. We're looking for the Lord God is the one. But they look for the figure of something, and that's what is wrong. And so for us, yes, God is there who searching for us, looking for us. Do we know, do we need to looking for Him at the time of need and humanity? Please stand up. And so we offer to our Lord our prayer.
That the church be a source of healing for all who grieve, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the terrors of war and genocide be remembered, and that peace reign over and reign in every land, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died enjoy in the blessings of God, light and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the memory of those who have died in the faith challenge the living to renewed service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That members of this assembly visit the sick, care for the dying, and comfort the mourners, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all those who have died, that they may enjoy the fullness of God's heavenly glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of Mickey McAuliffe, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer now our personal intentions. For these and all the prayers entered into our book of prayer and those that are held in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask you to bless upon the prayer that we offer you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, food of the earth and book of human hand. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the voice we offer you, food of the vine and book of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Oh, Jesus. Pray now that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice, the offering, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Lord, through whom you make all things, whom you send as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and giving for your holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured a passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice. Holy, holy, holy Lord.
God of hosts, heaven and earth, come from your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed, holy Lord, the fullness of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the breath of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. light of your faith. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray. That's with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, as well, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you through all the days, we may merit to be co-heir to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the sinful command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that, renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise through Christ our Lord. I thank you for keeping us praying. Yesterday we have the Presbyteral Council meeting all day, and then in the evening I mentioned to you that four representatives of the parish, St. Rita for visitation, Holy Rosary, and St. Anna, the state hall, that each parish have two representatives meet last night, and so they will share with you what will be going on. But my responsibility as your pastor is just let you know that four of the parishes have been meet and they working together as the deanery recommend and as the auspices recommend. And so for next few weeks, auspices will write a letter to each one of us and let us know what's going on, how the new parish will be. And so you know, and thank you for your prayer. Continue with the Presbyteral Council meeting today. I ask you to pray for us and also the consultant that will meet with us receive. And then tomorrow, the funeral, and then for Jesus. And then also we have Mass at 8, and I will let you know the following with the funeral. And also funeral on Saturday. Pray for all those who died and inquire the difficult for many family that have lost their loved one. So the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty